What an episode. What is up, guys? It's Chew here, bringing you another review on Black Clover. And I gotta say, we are starting the year right when it comes to these animes. Like, I'm really enjoying how we get a new opening, which was fire. I love the new opening. I love the new ending. It's kind of cool. It gives a lot of revelations. I'm an only anime only, but I could tell there's some big stuff going to be coming real soon. And I know the manga readers are like hyped as hell for it, and rightfully so. But for this episode, I love everything about it, because we have with Asta and trying to continue fighting Patry the best that they can. Nothing that they did was actually really getting through. Even their combined strength was enough to take them down. And then we get Nozel coming in here out of nowhere. Legitimately nowhere. And he comes in and he just becomes like the main attraction, because he actually stops Patry from continuing on. I love the way that he's able to basically counter the light magic that he has, and it was just a really good fight. Like, I wish we had gotten this from the beginning, but you gotta give the main character some shine, and Nozel coming in here, you know, and pretty much getting the job done was really cool. I love seeing that way he had that kind of like circular cage where he just traps Patry in there, which was awesome. I really like that. And he ends up taking them down. We get to see Raya watching this happen. And while he's watching, we also have Mimosa starting to heal him. I started thinking, you know, why is Mimosa even next to him and not already doing it? And so I guess after a moment of like, you know, brilliance, she comes to find out that maybe I should like help him out. And so I feel like from now on Raya's gonna be out, and maybe he'll have a change of heart after all this. I don't know, but I really like the fact that, you know, right when Nozel was gonna kill Patry, or at least attempt to, we have Asta stepping in and saying, no, don't do it, this isn't the way, I need him. I'm sorry, I'm just kind of quoting some Star Wars here. But we see that he actually uses a sword to try to, you know, kind of purify him and get Captain Vengeance out. Obviously, Nozel doesn't know the whole situation. He doesn't realize that this body does, in fact, belong to Vengeance. And so I'm waiting for this all huge revelation that some of them already know to come to fruition, and just everyone actually be up to date as to what's actually going on. And this is where the episode goes into a weird direction, but a kind of cool direction, because we get to see Asta getting absorbed by all the madness, and we hear Yuno screaming, Asta! And it's funny because, like, we get to see William kind of like in a tree, and we have Patry, like, in his younger form, being all, like, upset and kiddish and trying to run away. And while that's happening, we have Asta seeing all of his memories, all of his feelings, all of his doings just coming out. And you know that Asta is rightfully angry and upset for everything that he's seen and everything that Patry has done, especially coming to the killing of the Wizard King. That was something that, you know, rightfully so, would upset anyone that sees him the way that Asta does. And so when he actually gets to him, I thought, man, the hatred and the anger must have already gotten to him, and like, he must absorb a little bit by the way he was looking. He looked kind of evilish himself. And this is where we start to see the confrontation between the two, the exchange of words. Asta saying, I won't forgive you. I can't forgive you for what you've done. We're not so different. And, you know, Ningen this, all from Patry, which honestly got annoying, because he keeps saying Shine and Ningen. Like, what are you, Zamasu? Like, it was just getting a little frustrating for me personally to hear that's the only things he would say. But we have Asta kind of getting to him in the end. He ends up saving him. Luckily, he reverts Patry back to his normal form, and even Raya was surprised to see, you know, how this was happening. Like, he's being treated by Mimosa and Asta saving him. So it's like, you know, maybe the humans aren't so bad. And so now with Patry back to normal, I believe he's gonna actually, they're gonna join forces, and that's gonna be pretty badass. But then we get to have what is going on with the Akuma, and he actually is trying to get free, but he does have some resistance because we have Liched, who isn't fully awake, actually joining in the fray. He's not in his top strength. He's definitely not. I don't think he's probably going to be able to fight off Akuma until he gets some help. And he does. He gets Charlotte. Obviously, she's controlled. I don't remember the name of the elf that's controlling her. She jumps in to help out. And all of a sudden, just walking in, we get Yami. Yami's just coming in. And he's saying, oh my goodness, this guy just radiates bad, evil guy. Like, I can sense that he has nothing but dark ki in him. And I loved it because we have Charlotte possessed. Possessed Charlotte. And Yami fighting together, and they're making a great tag team. I just really enjoy that. And, you know, Yami just saying, you know, hey, you need to take care of that body because it ain't yours. I'm like, yeah, I know. Yeah, you better say that because it's your body, my dude. You like this body. You gonna be... Anyway, it was a great episode. I really enjoyed it. And then we get Nero talking. So it's gonna be dope to see what's gonna be happening. But guys, stay safe and catch you later.
Gavilán, Gavilán, loca, luna, espate los pelcos que yo tengo ahí. Tú y yo bellaqueando con la luna, vamos pa' mi cuarto y perdemos ahí. Loca, luna, espate los pelcos que yo tengo.